Champion Mike. She's got a better MA, and my hand did not come down on the three count. It stayed up on two. And then you, your emotions started getting a little heated, and you got up and got in my face, and I quickly backed up. I said, oh, thinking, and for a split second, I walked away to the other side of the ring. And then Sami Zayn rolled up Randy Orton, and then you dove into position, and you counted quickly, mind you. One, two, three.
He did. They need Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens.
Thus, Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn are still here. So, Daniel, I've explained what was going through my head. What was going through yours? I did what I did to protect you from yourself. Hey, Daniel.
Thank you, Daniel. They need Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens.
Getting back to what you just said, Daniel, with all due respect, I don't need protection from you.
Plenty of people beat up Vince McMahon. You know?
With all due respect...
Plenty of people beat up Vince McMahon.
Yes, you do. You see, because Shane, you eat, sleep, breathe SmackDown Live, but your passion can turn you into a hothead. I did what I did at Clash of Champions, not just to protect you, but to protect an idea. Our idea. I took this job as general manager because I believe in a shared vision. The shared vision of the land of opportunity. The land
protecting
of opportunity for everyone.
Yeah.
Not just people that you like.
Getting rid of two good wrestlers.
You may not like Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens. You may not like the way that they conduct themselves, but you threatened their livelihood, and not only that, you threatened to take away their opportunity that we promised to everyone.
True.
You know, Dan, I've been trying to figure this out, and I've been ruminating on this idea. And although the situation is completely different, I can understand how you personally have empathy for Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn. I just want to let you know, be very careful, because as soon as those two guys are done playing on your empathetic heartstrings, they're going to stab you in the back. And from a business standpoint, hear me out. It is imperative, and I caution you, not to show favoritism towards them, because that will come around and once again bite you right in the rear.
Yeah.
From a business standpoint, everybody. From a business standpoint. Are you saying I should have done what was best for business? Because I've heard those words before, and not only have I heard those words, I've struggled, I've fought against those words.
Yeah.
See, I believe in you,
Daniel Bryan, Triple H.
I believe in SmackDown Live, and I believe in our shared vision. Have a completely different vision, that's your prerogative. Oh. And if you want to fire somebody, fire me.
Oh. Don't know if this is a Daniel Bryan heel turn or not. The crowd likes Daniel Bryan more than Shane McMahon now. That's how over Daniel Bryan gets when he does the right thing.
Because I don't want to see Shane O'Mac turn in to Mr. McMahon.
It kind of sounds like what's going on right now, honestly. Here's your daddy. Crowd's totally against Shane. That'll be a double turn.
Well, Daniel. I respect you implicitly. I trust you. Good luck with the show tonight.
I guess that's it. Guess Daniel Bryan's gonna run the show. Guess it is what it is. Shane McMahon is kind of becoming Vince McMahon, the way he's acting and stuff, you know? Yeah, think about that for a minute. They like Daniel Bryan. Fans don't want Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens gone. They know that. Daniel Bryan's got this. Yes, yes, and yes. That's all I want to say.